iFish Chronicles, December 29, 2015. On location in beautiful Orlando, Florida. Getting ready to take the first swing ever at some Florida strain largemouth bass. On a beautiful Tuesday morning. I got brother-in-law Jeremy along. Father-in-law Guy, say hello, Guy.
Hello.
Are we ready to do this or what?
Let's rock and roll.
Let's rock and roll. The vessel for the morning is a 20-foot Triton Mercury Pro XS, ready to rock and roll. And our guide, Art Ferguson. Good morning.
Good morning.
Nice July day we're having.
A beautiful July day in December. We love it. He's loaded up. First fish of the day, iFish Chronicles.
Oh.
There you go, Jeremy. Oh, yeah. Now we're talking.
Don't horse it. Hold on.
Literally 2 minutes in, I think our guide, Art Ferguson, knows exactly what he's doing.
Yeah. Wow. He ate that big shiner.
Oops. That's all right. Hey, that's what we're talking about. 5 minutes in.
Wow.
Nice. Nice work.
Now don't try to horse it. It's not pulling. Let him fight.
Oh, yeah. There he is.
Don't pull. I mean, don't reel. I'm sorry. There you go.
Okay. Number two.
Where's your mama?
Yeah, where is the mama?
That one though, look at him.
Yeah, nice. Nice little girth on him. Healthy fish. Early in the day, and we've already stuck two fish. Nice job, Guy. Good work. Beautiful fish.
Beautiful day. Beautiful fish.
Absolutely. Give the folks an idea what kind of shiners we got going on there. Fairly decent size.
Yeah, this is actually small today. Wild shiner.
Just a wild shiner and a circle hook.
Mm-hmm.
And we're actually running them unweighted. We're just flopping them out and letting the baits free swim. It's a little bit like walleye fishing. And not even a lot of stuff on the graph. Like you said, it seems like... little bait. Oh yeah, now you can see them on the graph there, can't you? Yeah.
Yeah,
here. Right there. Interesting. So Art, when you run your season up on Lake Michigan, what kind of months are you guiding up there?
Lake St. Clair, guiding like late April, early May until late as people want to go in the cold, you know.
So oh, okay.
Mid-November this year.
Okay.
Yeah.
And then by December, you're relocated down here and ready to start guiding in the winter months. Part of the reason we came here, you talked about, was the spraying of Lake Toho, which is really a world-renowned lake, but part of the destruction process really messes with fish. Talk about that just a little bit.
Yeah. We have a lot of hydrilla in the lakes around Florida, and it's an invasive species, they call it. So because of that, they try to control it, and through their controlling, they never seem to get it right.
They never seem to get it right.
Overspray and kill too much of it, and it wipes out the natural, well, what we consider natural habitat. And the bass love hydrilla, and they always seem to want to take it away.
Yeah.
Both here and in Okeechobee, and it can be devastating the lakes, you know, for months.
Yeah.
No, but it's still a great lake. It's still one of the best lakes.
And even this chain we're on, we're talking, you know, 8-9 pound fish are always a possibility.
Oh,
anyway.
Yeah. Any second.
Any second. All right. Let's hope that any second is coming up for me here pretty soon.
Yeah.
I've got zero fish on the board. Unacceptable. Guy, you're leading me. What's the deal with that?
Well,
all right, let's get back to it. Well, after a couple of early morning fish, decided to connect through into a different lake. Some of the properties on this chain is just absolutely spectacular. I guess some of them must be pro athletes or something. Crazy homes. Feels like a little lake like Minnetonka right in here, actually. Did you see one in the canal back there? Did you? Oh, there's another one right off to the left, about a 3-pounder. There's another one right there, about a 2-pounder. Tough day of fishing so far, just two. Some minnows breaking across the water in here. Big bass right there on the right, about 4-pounder. We're seeing most of the bass in the canals between the lakes. Nothing real huge yet though. Little baby bass there. No. Doesn't seem to be much rhyme or reason.
I don't think they can find these canals here. I've never seen them.
You don't see any residual of like old, there's another bass there. You don't see any old beds either, you know. No circles anywhere.
Okay. Oh, so you're controlling the depth of that shiner? Oh, I didn't know that. Okay. How fast are you trolling?
Like, I don't know. I mean, I just know by feel.
1.5 mile an hour?
Up to about that, yeah.
Oh, okay.
We're at about 0.2, 0.3. We've been up 0.8 before.
Okay. Oh, I'm learning.
Absolutely.
Yeah, just keep the rod bending. Slow it down.
We are on a school of fish in lake number 3. Things have really picked up. Jeremy's had bites. I had about a 4 or 5 pounder come up, spit my minnow. Guy just lost one, now we got another one in the back. As soon as we're getting the minnow out there, they're smashing it. Oh, nice fish.
Oh, what?
Oh yeah, now we're talking.
So what size is that?
Now we're talking. It's a little better.
Half maybe?
It's a little better. Hold her up for the picture there, guy.
Right up there.
Nice. iFish Chronicles, Florida strain. Guy Davey whacking them. Huh. Nice fish. All right, go ahead and toss them back in. Sweet. That's more like it.
What's going on, Kurt? Guys, 2 for 2.
Yeah, I know. Yeah, I know. Rub it in. Keep rubbing it in. I appreciate it. Thanks. Let's make fun of Kurt, the cameraman, more. That's awesome. All right, let's get him. Guy has got the hot hand. Maybe we, instead of iFish Chronicles, I should just call it Guyfish. Guyfish Chronicles. Gosh. Kicking the host's butt here. Got a double? Oh, nice one. Look at that bass. Number 4 of the day. You were holding the line and it just crushed it?
Yeah.
Really?
Oh, you told it too quick to hit it.
Alright, guy, I'm gonna get a still photo with you this one too.
That could just be the shiner?
Yeah, I mean, it's gonna hit it most likely.
Okay. Okay.
Uh-oh, guy's got another one.
He sure does, doesn't he?
Look at that.
He's on fire. Hard. You got him. Nice job.
Yeah, because when I'm hit. Well, see, I'm getting one too.
Oh, no.
line again. Keep pressure on him.
Oh, we lost him.
Oh.
So what are you saying? There is a fish on Jerry's line?
It's huge. It's like 20 inches.
It's a gar.
Oh, it is.
Oh, no way. It's a gar, huh?
Have you ever caught a gar?
No, I've never caught a gar. I saw the back of that one earlier on the first lake when it came up to the surface. The heaviest fish you've ever caught, Jeremy?
Probably the heaviest
fish you've ever caught?
Catch many of these out here.
I'm surprised that they're just mixed right in with the bass, especially for as established as this school of basses that we've got on.
Yeah, don't try to reel, there's a lot of them.
Sweet, dude.
He's coming. Here he comes.
The Igar Chronicles. Way cool. Wow, look at that, dude. Cool.
Oh, man, he's got teeth.
It's nothing but teeth. Look at all the teeth, dude. Yeah, it's nothing but teeth.
Oh, he'll slice you in half.
Oh, yeah, look at the teeth. There, you get a good look at him right there.
Oh, wow.
That is awesome. Oh, there it went.
Well, I didn't know. You
saw it hit it, didn't you?
Well, yeah.
Well, I heard you yell like, "There's one right there."
Yeah, he'll slice you right in half.
Oh, dude, that was one teeth. Sweet, very cool, man. Very cool. Tanker. Absolute tanker!
Awesome. How big do you think he is?
It's gotta be 21 inch fish, right? Have you got a tape measure?
Yeah.
Let's measure him up.
Nice net job, huh?
Yeah!
Hold on.
The minnow's still got a lot of energy. Guy, you got him. Got him. Real. Nice. Jumped into my line, just to be aware of it. You're all right.
All right, guys on the board.
Guys,
nice.
Nice, good.
Good job, guys.
Okay. There you go, Jeremy. Lift that rod tip.
Sounds like a nice one.
Yeah, move some water. Another healthy fish. Nice.
Oh wow.
All right, we gotta keep this down just for a second while this boat's going by.
Yeah, absolutely. If it asks,
I got it. That's a bass. I saw it.
down.
Nice one.
Yeah.
Nice fish. There you go. I thought it was a little heavier than that. Still nice. 17 inch fish. Nice fish. Another one on the fake baits.
Wow, that's crazy. Oh, wow. That's
oh, nice healthy fish, too. Real nice healthy fish. Beautiful. Hey, that's what we're talking about. Great fish, Art.
Thanks.
Nice work. Yeah, nice work.
You guys are sitting there with your live bait with nothing, and I'm picking them.
What's that, your third one now?
Yeah.
Nice one.
Oh, wow. Oh, that's nice.
Grab my rod and hold the line. Hog. Oh, my gosh. Wow. Hog.
You gotta be kidding.
Whoa.
That made me feel kind of bad.
Oh, are you kidding? Look at that beast.
That's where we're out here fishing for, guys.
That's than all. Wow. Toad.
Yeah, fuck that real quick.
Absolute toad. Let me get out of your way here.
Yeah, he's there.
Oh. Stop reeling and lift your rod to. Oh!
Started with a little one, ended with a little one.
Ended with a little one. That's right.
Yeah,
that's
nice. Right. Cool. You got it. Cool.
Yeah. Awesome.
Good end job. Of the day, man. Woo. Nice.
The first one and the last one.
Nice. You did, didn't you? A fitting end.
Oh, guy didn't start off with the one. No, you did. Yeah.
No, I did.
Yeah.
Good job.
Sweet.
Awesome.